Welcome, everybody, to Hymn Sing tonight. You've been listening to Tony Rogers, who's with us again tonight. He's been throughout this last year and a half, been with us several times, and it's always a joy to have Tony with us. He plays regularly here at Riverbend Church, and a wonderful cellist, and always enjoy the times with him. So thank you for tuning in tonight. We're going to do some hymns. I think all of you, most of you will know all these songs tonight. We may throw in one or two you might be unfamiliar with, but for the most part, we try to keep this something that you can enjoy, that you know, that's familiar, and that you may have sung all your life, or maybe it's new to you. For some of you that might be a little younger, some of these hymns may be brand new songs. And I find that to be true more and more the longer I'm in ministry, that so many people, you'll do a hymn that you've sung all your life, and there'll be people that say, hey, is that a new song? No, it was written about 200 years ago. So you know how that is, Tony.
I do.
It's like even with classical music, you know, some of these tunes are new.
And you've chosen some old ones here.
Tonight I have, and your mom.
From my youth. Yeah, my mom might be watching, so I'm excited. I hope you enjoy it, Mom.
Good to have you here, Tony. So we'll start with this great, actually this tune was originally out of a Beethoven tune. And so joyful, joyful, we adore thee. Sing this with us. Sing it with us. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. Tony, play it for us. God of glory, Lord of love, every good thing comes from you. May we glorify your name in all we do. In all we do. Mortals join the happy chorus, which the morning stars began. Father, love is reigning o'er us. Mother, love binds man to man. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us on in the triumph song of life. God of glory, Lord of love, every good thing comes from you. May we glorify your name in all we do. Sing that with us. God of glory. God of glory, Lord of love, every good thing comes from you. May we glorify your name in all we do. In all we do. You'll know this one. Sing it with us. I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder how he could love me, a sinner condemned unclean, singing how marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall sing that chorus, singing how marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. When with the ransomed in glory his face I at last shall see, 'twill be my joy through the ages to sing of his love for me. Sing it now. Singing how marvelous, how shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall That's a good one. I know you'll know this one and can sing along. As I've said before, I grew up as a Southern Baptist kid in Texas, and most of my life I've been a music minister in that denomination and at Riverbend for almost 32 years. It's hard to believe. But I've done this most of my life, and I always remember that this hymn that we're doing next was hymn number one in the Baptist hymnal, well, before the new edition. So I used to know all those numbers by memory. You know, we used to get up and say that as we get up. We always said in church, even though we didn't have screens back then, Tony, where you could, like, have the lyrics. Everybody still had hymnals. Now, in this building, our chapel service still does use hymnals, just like we did. So we would get up as the music pastor and say, turn in your hymnals to hymn number one and sing verse number 1, 2, and 4. Okay. In the Baptist church, we left out a couple because we did. In the Methodist church, they did all the verses. so it might take all day. And besides that, usually the organist played a verse through before it even started. So, you know, you could take 7 minutes for a hymn. So that's like a modern worship chorus. Now, all those are 7 minutes. So anyway, holy, 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 you know this one. Sing it now. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, all thy works shall praise thy name in earth and sky and sea. He is a holy God, and he is a great God. This is an older worship chorus that we're going to put together with a hymn that you know, How Great Thou Art. But How Great Is Our God is one of my favorite early Chris Tomlin choruses. I love the lyrics, the splendor of the King, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. Let's sing it together. Tony, you're going to play it for us first. Sing it with me now, The Splendor. The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light. Darkness tries to hide and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. Sing it out. How great is our God. Sing with me. How great is our God. And all will see how great. How great is our God. Then sings my soul. Now sing it. How great is our God?
How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And all will see how great. How great is our God? How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And all will see how great. How great is our God? How great.
Amazing love that welcomes me, the kindness of mercy that bought with blood wholeheartedly My soul undeserving. Sing it now. God is so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. Behold the cross, age to age, and hour by hour, the dead are raised, the sinner saved, the work of your power. Sing it out. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. So good to play that for us, Tony. Should this life bring suffering, Lord, I will remember what Calvary has bought for me, both now and forever. Sing it again now. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. God, you're so good. Love that piece. Learn that chorus. We were talking about Tony earlier. You know, we all learned, I think, that chorus sometime in our Christian life. God, you're so good, or God is so good, however you learned it. And we used to change the words and go, he answers prayer, he answers prayer. I mean, we made all, back when choruses first started being written, and I'm old enough to be there. I'm almost old enough to, like, remember when Amazing Grace was written, but I'm not quite that old. Not really. But back in those days, usually there were choruses, and even up till the last few years, you know, a lot of the choruses were very repetitive, and they basically said the same words over and over, so we'd have to make up different words, you know, to keep the variety, and they were fairly short. But that was one of those songs, and what I've loved now is a lot of the writers today, arrangers today, are taking songs like that, which the Passion Group did out of Atlanta, and wrote verses to it. We talked about that earlier. So we knew the chorus, but then they added the verses. And then Chris Tomlin is really well known. His first big song is so funny that his first big hit, that no telling how much money he's made off of it, but is Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. Well, basically, he wrote a little chorus to add to Amazing Grace. So he borrowed that great hymn. But I love that because then it ties the old to the new. I love that combination. So now this is a song that was written probably in the 70s, more than likely. I first heard it in a musical, but a beautiful melody and some lyrics. And it encourages us to just give thanks to God for we've been singing about him and how wonderful he is, and he's so good. So let's take a moment in our evening to give thanks to him for all he is in our life. In the good and the bad, he is there, okay? And that's the thing we got to remember. He doesn't ever promise that we're always going to have good, and it's not always going to be joyous, but he promises to be there in the midst of all of it. And that's what gives me hope and courage in the midst of anything I go through in my life, is that he promises that he will be there in the midst of it. So let's give thanks to that. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. Play it, Tony. Thank you. Sing it now. And now let the weak say I am strong. Let the poor say I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Oh, give thanks. Oh, Lord, we give you thanks. Thank you for being in our lives. Wonderful song. All right, we're going to pick it up. Now, this is a more traditional hymn, new version of a traditional hymn that we didn't sing as much in the Baptist church, but I know maybe you Methodists, some of you Methodists, they're probably singing this every week. God of grace and God of glory. Anybody know that hymn? Don't give me those blank stares, you people in the audience. Some of you will know. You'll know this melody, okay? We're introducing a new hymn. That was probably written, let's see when it was written. Oh, it doesn't have the copyright information on here. But a while back. Okay, here we go. One, two, three, four. Probably wasn't written like this. And God of glory, on thy people pour thy power. Crown thine ancient church's story, bring her but to glorious flower. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage, for facing of this hour, for the facing of this hour. Okay, play it, Tony. Scorn thy Christ, assail his ways. From the fears that long have bound us, free our hearts to faith and praise. Grant us wisdom, grant us courage for the living of these days. Praise. about you learned a new one tonight? How about that? This is a new song that I did in church not too long ago. I love David Crowder. And in the last several years, I mean, he's been writing great worship songs. And but lately, he's been writing these great melodies and just sort of more almost country, sort of folky sort of stuff that's really, really good. And this is a new one. I just love the message of this song. Starts, the first verse is, if you're troubled, heavy-hearted, come to Jesus and find your peace. If you're run down, how many anybody run down in here tonight? Do you ever get run down? I do. I'm getting old. That's what it is. No, I'm not supposed to say that. I'm not getting old. Right, Tony?
No, not at all.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Tony's young. See, he doesn't get it. Anyway, if you're run down, empty-handed, come to Jesus and find your strength. He is hope for the hopeless, rest for the weary, help for the hurting. He is. He is mending the broken, bearing the burdens, all that you're needing. He is. Man, it's great. It's simple, but man, it's a great song. Let's worship with this. If you're troubled, heavy-hearted, come to Jesus and find your peace. If you're run down, empty-handed, come to Jesus and find your strength. He is hope for the hopeless, rest for the weary, help for the hurting. He is mending the broken, bearing the burdens, all that you're needing. He is. If you're wandering in the darkness, come to Jesus and find your way. And if you want freedom and need forgiveness, just come to Jesus and find his grace. He is hope for the hopeless, rest for the weary, help for the hurting. He is mending the broken, bearing the burdens, all that you're needing. Comforter, counselor, prince of peace, author and maker of everything, defender, deliverer, king of kings. He is helper and healer forevermore, savior and shelter through every storm, my refuge, redeemer, and Lord of lords. He is child of heaven and son of man, provider, protector, the great I am, Alpha, Omega, beginning and end. He is hope for the hopeless, rest for the weary, help for the hurting. He is mending the broken, bearing the burdens, all that you're needing. He is. All that you're needing. He is. Thank you, David Crowder, for that one. Beautiful, beautiful lyrics. I've done this one a couple times during the hymn sing during this last year and a half. Still hard to believe it's been that long that we've been doing this, and this year and a half has been chaotic, to say the least. I think it's taught us all a lot. We've had a lot of pain, a lot of joy, a little bit of everything. Besides all the interesting freezes that we had in February, man, this has been quite a few months. Just let God's peace flood over you, no matter what's going on in your life. I love the words of this old hymn, "Wonderful Peace." Far away in the depths of my spirit tonight rolls a melody sweeter than song. In celestial-like strains, it unceasingly rolls o'er my soul like an infinite calm. Peace, peace, sing it. Peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray, in fathomless billows of love. I am resting tonight in this wonderful peace, resting sweetly in Jesus' control. For I'm kept from all danger by night and by day, and His glory is flooding my soul. Sing it with me now. Peace, 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 wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above. Sweet. Forever I pray, in fathomless billows of love. Sing it one more time. Peace, peace, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above.
fathomless billows of love.
Amen. Still one of my favorites. We're going to stay in that mode, just a song here. This tune, we've talked often every week about different songs we use for what we call the invitation, you know, Tony.
Sure.
You said your mother liked this next song.
This is my mom. This one's for you, Mom. Coming out to you. Yeah, she's going to love this one.
This is a beautiful, one of those invitation hymns, we called it, in the church, where at the end of the service, these could last for eternity. But we thought Jesus would come back before it was over many times. I don't know how many of you have ever been in churches like that. You know, it's Riverbend, we sort of do that privately after service. You know, we have people that can talk to folks and all that. But this was a really big deal, and still is. A lot of churches still do these altar calls or whatever. There's different terms for them where you have a period of time. And these songs were written specifically for invitations. But this is a beautiful melody and a beautiful lyric that invites you. It says, you know, he's not screaming at you. He's talking to you softly and tenderly. Jesus is calling. Let's do this one, Tony.
You just gave it away, but okay.
I know. 1, 2, 3. Sing it with us now.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling for you and for me. See on the portals, he is waiting and watching, watching for you and for me. Come home.
Sing that chorus again. Come home.
Come home. Come.
Calling, oh sinner, come. Amen. All right, we're going to wrap it up tonight, but let me remind you that at the end of June, we're going to be doing a really cool thing. We're sort of wrapping up, at least for the summer. We'll bring it back in some form in the fall, but we're getting ready to start our choir again, and we'll be meeting again on Wednesday nights and getting things going. It's going to get really busy, so we're going to try to figure out a way to do the hymn sing later on after we get that going, but at the end of June, leading up to that, next week, my guest is Jerry Wise, who y'all love and appreciate. He's a fantastic worship leader over at Covenant Presbyterian Church, and love to sing with Jerry. He'll be here, and then the following week, we're going to do a little gospel night with Angie Kogutz. That'll be fun. Then we're going to close it with our entire, basically our entire band, most of our band from Riverbend Church in the Celebrate service. We're going to do a country gospel sort of celebration on the last Wednesday night, and we're inviting everybody. We want you to come live, so if you invite your friends, we're going to fill this place. The balcony hopefully is just packed, and we're going to lift the roof with these old songs that everybody will know, and we're going to have a great time. And as you know, the band is fantastic, and will just lift your heart. So we invite you to that, and continue to listen, and thank you so much for tuning in each week during this. Many of you have watched every week. And if you've missed a few, they're all online on our Facebook page. You can go back and watch any of the programs through the last year and a half. So thank you so much. We're going to close the service tonight with a song that many of us in all denominations either started the service or ended the service with. So we're going to close with Doxology. All right? Sing it. I think you know this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sing it now.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Let's stand and sing it. If you're in the crowd, let's sing it.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for being here tonight. God bless you. See you next week.